the topic which has been given to me is the legal drafting. Topic is very vast, and in 90 minutes I will try to cover it, but which is not possible anyhow. I will give you the glimpses, and I will be very slow so that your other brothers also come. Actually, first of all, as an advocate, responsibility is that you should seek the instructions of your client. When you are fully instructed, then in that way you will be in a position to draft a thing legally. Whether that is pleading, that is convincing, or any other draft which require under the law to be drafted, unless and until you seek the instructions of the client, you will not be in a position to draft it. You are advocate of the High Court or of the trial courts. Recently enrolled as an advocate, recently. So, Lord Macaulay, in his wisdom, has prepared three books. One is Pakistan Penal Code, which define the crimes, offenses, and then is Criminal Procedure Code, which show the procedure, how to reach that place. For example, you go to Peshawar, then this is substantive law. Your aim is to go to Peshawar. How to reach it, whether by car, by train, or by public service vehicle, that is the procedure. So in criminal cases, they have divided it to the penal code and to the procedural law, criminal procedure code. But in civil law, this procedural law and substantive law, it has been embodied in one book, which is called Civil Procedure Code. The section parts is substantive law. The orders part is procedural law. So, first of all, you will determine your goal, where you are going. So, seek the instructions of your client. Now, legal drafting is divided into two parts. One is pleadings under the Civil Procedure Code. Now, in pleading, you must know that first of all, you will determine the court, to which court you are going. Determination of court is very necessary, because that gives the jurisdiction which you will acquire, you will gain, you will receive your own goal for which you are contesting the case of the client. So, Civil Procedure Code, first section parts are substantive. Procedural part is orders part. Now, if you open order 5, it defines the pleading. 5, 6, plaint and written statement. So, first of all, you will describe the court to which you are submitting, the jurisdiction of the court. If the court has got the jurisdiction, then you will draft the plaint. Plaint, name of the court, name of the parties, plaintiff and defendant, the value for the purpose of jurisdiction and court fee, under the Court Fees Act and under the Suit Valuation Act. Then you will select the forum, whether this court has got the jurisdiction or not. Whether to the court to which I am submitting my client, that court has got the jurisdiction. If that court has got the jurisdiction, then you will determine the valuation. Valuation is very important. Valuation for the purpose of court fee and valuation for the purpose of jurisdiction. Now, this valuation is important because under the Civil Court Ordinance Section 13 and 16, it determines the forum of your appeal. In case suit is dismissed or relief is not given to you, what will be the forum of your appeal, where you will go? So this section 16-13 has been subject matter of various changes. Originally 25,000 was the basic jurisdiction and value of the civil judge, first class or senior civil judge. So in that case, up to 25, the appeal would have been filed before the district judge, and above 25, the regular first appeal would go to the High Court, directly leaving the district and session judge. It was enhanced to 5 lakhs, then it was enhanced to 1 million. Now it has been enhanced to 10 millions, 1 crore, up to 1 crore, the civil judge first class or the senior civil judge has got the jurisdiction. And the moment 1 rupee is enhanced, then the appeal would lie to the High Court and not to the district judge. Because now up to 10 million rupees, the district judge can hear a case. So this is the forum of appeal, which is determined by your valuation. Whatever you write in the plaint, that will determine the forum of appeal. So stick to it, concentrate upon it, study section 7 of the Court Fees Act and section 11 of the suit, section 2 of the Suit Valuation Act, which give you the forum of appeal and the forum of jurisdiction. Now another important aspect in criminal cases, because you will not only devote yourself to the civil side, your junior, you will ask, you will present yourself before the litigants and they will select, criminal case will come to you, civil case will come to you. So in criminal cases, draft strictly, because your drafting tells upon your personality. When you draft things beautifully and the judge see it, it reflects your personality. And when you are a good drafter, legal drafter, drafter according to law, then that is a good impression on the judge hearing the case. So while drafting the bail application, you must take all the grounds possible in the bail application. Name of the court, state versus flana, full address, charge under section, complete sections, then FIR number, police station. So all these things should be specifically written. Then when you write, then you must concentrate upon all the grounds. Take all the grounds in your bail application. Because while drafting the bail application, you have got only the FIR. Other record is not available. So take possible, all possible grounds in your bail application. And when you draft it beautifully, that is a beautiful effect on the mind of the judge. So while drafting it, then you must draft it very elaborately. Name of the court, state versus name of the accused, or accused versus state, name of the accused, father name, address, police station, FIR number, section of law under which your client has been charged. So it should be specifically mentioned. Now, this is under section 497, because while doing your apprenticeship, your senior must have asked that this is under section 497 of the criminal procedure. Now, bail is rejected or bail is accepted. In that case, either of the party go to the session court. That is not an appeal. That is a bail cancellation application. If it is rejected, this application is competent before the session judge. If it is accepted, that court can also, under section 497, subsection 5, assume the jurisdiction, either cancelling or not cancelling. But if you want to go to the High Court or Session Court, That is not an appeal. That is an application under Section 498 of the Criminal Procedure. So keep it in mind that applications, bail treat with applications only. There is no concept of appeal. Appeal concept comes when a person is convicted. If he is convicted up to 3 years, then the appeal lies to the session judge. If it is above, the cumulative sentence is above 3 years, it goes to the High Court. But at the moment, you are advocates of the trial courts, so concentrate upon it, study it, the law, and according to law, draft your pleadings, bail application, appeals. Now, cases will come to you under the Land Acquisition Act, compulsory land acquisition. Government acquire the land for the public purpose. So for that you are also required to have knowledge of the legal drafting. How you will draft? That is called a reference under Section 18 of the Land Acquisition Act. And the ingredients are, you can challenge the quantum of compensation, the measurement of land, and the apportionment of compensation. Apportionment means that if there is dispute between the two co-sharers or among so many co-sharers, the question will be how this compensation will be apportioned. It will be distributed among the co-share. So under Section 18 of the Land Acquisition Act, this is the exclusive jurisdiction of the court which has been notified through a notification by the Prime Minister. That is called referee court under Section 18 of the Land Acquisition Act. Now mind it and take note that that application will be presented to the land acquisition collector. The person, there is a person, land acquisition collector, who is a judge between the owners and the government. When he acquires the land, then under Section 18, you will file application before the collector. You cannot go directly to the court. In that application, you will say that is called reference application, that we have not accepted your award, we are challenging it, you have under-assessed, undervalued our land by awarding meager compensation. So you must refer this matter to the court constituted through a notification. He may be either senior civil judge or additional district and session judge. So the matter will be referred. Then the procedure is just like the plain written statement, recording of evidence. But that is the exclusive jurisdiction of the referee court. Now, appeal in that case, even if the valuation is rupees 1, appeal under Section 53 of the Land Acquisition Act would lie to the High Court and not to the Session Court. Session Court had got no jurisdiction to entertain that regular first appeal. That would lie to the High Court. So these are various legal aspects of the case, that while legally drafting, you must, before the land acquisition collector, name of the parties, name of the acquiring department, the department for which the land has been acquired, and all the functionaries of the state who participated in the award, they must be made as party, and then it will be presented to the collector, that collector who acquired the land, who announced the award, and the appeal would lie to the. So your legal drafting, if not explanatory, if it is not in detail, that will have very bad impression on the judge to whom you are presenting yourself. Now, sometime it happens that in family court cases, unfortunately, we do not adopt the right way. We take the instructions, our plaint is neither readable nor explanatory, and sometimes, unfortunately, they say, in so many cases, as a judge as well as an advocate, I have come across the cases that they say this was the dower fixed, but dower was paid and it was snatched away from the wife. In that case, the jurisdiction, once it is paid and then it is snatched, then according to the wisdom of the judges, the jurisdiction lies with the civil court and not with the family court. But here a question arises that section Schedule 5 attached to the Family Court Act, it has been substantially now amended. Because prior for dowry, we used to go to the family court, to the civil court, and for dower, whether prompt or deferred, we used to go to the family court, which was very harsh for the female who had come to the court, because they used to traverse the court premises for years without getting any relief. Now that schedule has been amended, and anything belonging to the wife, that become the personal property of the wife, and if it is taken or snatched, even then the civil court has got the jurisdiction. Then it used to come in judgments through courts, and before me also as an advocate or as a judge, that family court has got no power of partition, to partition. They say that for partition you will go through an application to the civil court under the Partition Act 1940, and then relief will be given. Then when I studied and I came across the case law and I applied my mind, so again this is now a question of legal drafting. If you draft your plaint that look, this house bounded is under, to north is the property of A, to south is the property of B, to east and west, you describe it by boundary and then annex a site plan. So when annex a site plan, then automatically it is partition. For example, there is a house 5-10 marlas, and dower 5 marla house has been given. But you describe in your plan, this is now the draftsmanship of the advocate, that how he beautifully couch the plaint. And couching of the plaint is that you will do it through boundaries. You will partition it in the plaint, annexing a site plan. So when the case came before me, I said that it has been already partitioned because boundaries have been shown in the plan. And kindly note a very well-known judgment on these 2 points, when the dower is snatched away, whether the civil court has got the jurisdiction or the family court. Kindly write Muhammad Tariq versus Musamati Shaheen. You will get very easily, kindly note. This is PLD 2006 Peshawar, page 189. Study it. How the property or the dower or the money. Page is, sir, 189. Then the question that whether the property is not partition or whether the court can grant a decree for partition to the wife. On that, kindly note PLD 2008 Peshawar,